afternoon baseball here on the show. It's the home opener of this new season between the New York Yankees and the Tycoons. It was an extra long wait for the fans in their new city, but it's finally time for their home opener. Quite an exciting day. Here's Heidi Watney with more.
The fans had to wait just a touch longer than they would have liked with the squad opening the season on the road. But the ribbon has finally been cut here in their new home, and there's a palpable sense of excitement in the locker room as well, with the players and coaches alike eager to get out on the field and start this new era. It is a banner day for this franchise, Matt.
Set for what should be a good one. Lineups and first pitch are next. Number 40 gets the ball for the opener in front of these hometown fans. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
It's not easy as a rookie to go out there and establish yourself, get the off-speed pitches over, and just try to be the same pitcher that you were in the minor leagues. And one of the big keys, not get ahead of yourself.
Now at the plate is Gio Urshela, and we are ready for some daytime baseball. The 1-1 home. And he fouls this one off. Our temperature 74 degrees as we get things started this afternoon. The 1-2 misses for the second ball. Fastball swung on and missed, and the leadoff man is gone on strikes to start the afternoon.
Talk about blowing it by a guy. Geez, I mean, that fastball was way behind him when the swing came through the zone. I have to think he was looking for something off speed, and he just couldn't pull the trigger on that fastball.
Stepping in now, Aaron Hicks. All even now, 2-2.
Hey, that's a good sinker right there. That's his bread and butter pitch, and if he's got that going, especially early, it's going to be tough to get some runs off it.
A little late with the swing, but he stays alive, still 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch. Chopper to short. Barehanded at his knees. What a way to get it out. Two gone now. That was exceptional. With that, here's a look at the Yankees' starting lineup. Danny, who stands out to you?
Well, man, we all know it. The man to watch, Giancarlo Stanton.
He's such a great talent, the kind of talent that can dominate a game, a perennial all-star, and win some awards. He's one of the best in the game today, and he's always fun to watch.
Into the box, DJ LeMahieu. And now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1. Guys, you take a look at the home nine as they enter play here this afternoon. They come off another loss last time out, and in fact, they've dropped three of their last four.
Yeah, Matty B, we got a couple of teams right now that haven't been playing very good baseball, D-Ro. One of these two teams needs to get things turned around and start things off on a good note and win.
And we'll just leave it there as they make the play to end the inning. 1-2-3 go the Bombers. We'll go to the bottom of the first in a scoreless ball game. Now into the box, number one. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. And the payoff pitch. He sends it out to left field. Well hit. And goodbye. This one ain't coming back. And good for him. Has just launched his first major league home run. Hard to say how many more of these he'll hit in his career, but for now, I'm sure he's happy to say he's got at least one.
Well, I think that any kid who's ever dreamed about playing this game dreams exactly this. Watching the ball disappear over the fence, then circling the bases in a big league ballpark. He'll be replaying that at-bat over and over in his head. And now his phone's going to blow up. He'll be calling his parents, his buddies. Everybody's going to be talking about this one.
Plate now, number 55. And I believe they'll say he broke the plane, as yes, he did. It's ruled a strike. Boy, good cutting action to that pitch as that's the first out of the inning.
That's a pretty unique pitch sequence, guys. Usually, pitching is all about mixing pitches and location. But he threw that all out the window to get that strikeout. He offered the same pitch three times in a row. So I guess he sort of used that reverse psychology to outthink his opponent.
At the plate, number 23. And he takes one off the inside corner for ball two. Well, this Yankee ball club entering play this afternoon here, they haven't quite been able to get on track yet. They come in 2-4 over their first six games.
Yeah, Matty, to expect to go through the course of a long season and just dominate every game, every team, is just a foolish thought process. You're going to have these little hiccups throughout the course of the season. I think they keep you honest and keep you real and keep you on the attack. Let's see if they fight today.
Batting.
And with that, here's a glance at the starting lineup for the home squad. Mark DeRosa, what's the key to them starting out 1-0 here at home?
Well, Matty, if I could tell this lineup one thing, it would be, let's get on this guy early. Day game in this ballpark, the sun starts glaring, starts getting later in the day, those shadows start creeping in right around the time that bullpen starts getting warmed up. Gotta find a way to scratch a few across early.
Even count, two balls and two strikes. Still 2-2. Two out, nobody on. And that one never threatened the zone. It's gone full now to 3-2.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
And it's fouled away. Oh, they think they may have gotten him again. This one's hit deep to left field. And for the second time in the inning, the Gopher ball will come back to bite him. It's a home run. So a solo shot down the line in left. First home run of the campaign for him, as it's now a 2-0 ball game. To the plate, Chen hit hard down the line, and this will stay inside the third base bag, a fair ball, and now it'll kick around in the corner, and he will pull into second with a two-out double.
When he started this game, giving up three extra base hits in the opening frame was not what he had in mind. He could still settle down and turn things around on the mound, but the way it's going right now, this has the makings of a start he's going to want to forget.
Into the box now, number 24. And he lays off the breaking ball there as he moves ahead to 2-1. Swings through it for strike number two.
Hey, after that extra base hit, things could go awry. He didn't. He battled right back in his zone with a nice executed pitch.
Swing and a looper to left. And that's going to fall for a base hit. The throw home. And this will not be close, and the run will score easily.
Batter seven, the second baseman, number 17.
Stepping in now, number 17. Ground ball sent back up the middle. A dive, and he knocks it down. And he'll make it to first easily on what will almost certainly be ruled an infield single.
Not
shortstop. Well, you know, D-Ro, every pitcher loves that. Shortstop does a great job just to knock that ball down to keep it from the outfield, to keep that runner from advancing all the way to home.
Yeah, and as a former middle infielder, Dan, we love this stuff. This is what gets you jacked up, trying to save runs for your pitcher, give you another chance to execute and get us out of this inning.
Working for the punch out and the offering. And the curveball bounces here, but a good job behind the plate to keep it at arm's length. Three runs already home here. And he strikes him out here, so he's able to stop the bleeding a bit as the side is retired. So they strike for three runs on five hits, no errors, and a couple of men left on. One inning in the books here. Chinese Taipei is out in front here, 3-0. Here's Big Aaron Judge. Was an 0-for-4 effort for him in Wednesday's ball game.
Hey, Matty, they need to get some offense going in this one. Getting a run back in this inning, give them a little bit of confidence that they can keep up in this game.
And the 2-1. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Number 24 is there, and he'll bring this one in.
Batting fifth.
Time for a look at the defensive alignment for the home team. And guys, what I want you to focus on today is this is one of the new age teams in the game that really rely on statistics and the numbers. And the numbers tell them that they're a better team defensively, moving guys around and shifting as much as they can.
1-2 now.
Hey, I still believe in my heart the best pitch is a well-executed fastball down and away, and that's exactly what that is. He swings at that. That's off the end of the bat. That's not hard contact at all, and that's an easy out for the defense.
Not every day that you see a ball come off the bat like that one did, and looking at it again on show track, we see it a lot faster than it came in, 113 miles an hour. Couldn't have hit that one much better than that. Standing in now, Luke Voit. A line shot to third base. And it got there so quickly, the runner didn't get very far from the bag. They settle with just the one out.
Batting seven, the left fielder, Giancarlo Stanton.
So next to hit is Giancarlo Stanton. He takes his first cuts in this one with a man at first and two away. Now the 1-1 pitch. Hit on the ground to third. Fielded cleanly. Throw to second for the force out, and the side is retired. The Yanks leave one. They trail in this one 3-0. Now at the plate, number 34. Three hits for him in that ball game on Wednesday. And he's keeping it down here, and that's a called strike two. Swung on in the dirt for the third strike. Higashioka goes to get it. The throw to first is in time, one down.
Now batting, number one,
Digging in next, number one. He'll look to duplicate his first at-bat when he homered to open the inning. The 1-1.
Count is one and two.
One out, nobody on. A swing and a miss for out number two, and a ball he had no chance of making contact with.
He's looking a lot sharper and has settled in here in the second inning.
55.
It'd be hard not to, because that first inning was pretty much a mess. But I give him credit for letting it go and making some really good adjustments.
To the plate now, number 55. And he pulled up in time, but it's a called strike two.
This could be a huge win for the guy on the mound if he's able to get out of this inning 1-2-3 and start fresh next inning with the middle of the order.
That's lifted the other way out to left. Stanton has a read on it. He handles it easily, and the inning is over. Top of the third set to get underway, and now it'll be the catcher, Kyle Higashioka. The 1-1. A swing and a ground ball to third. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third.
Batting ninth, the shortstop, Tyro Estrada.
So bases are empty with one gone, and that brings up Tyro Estrada. Here's the 1-2 delivery. Hard hit ball to short. In time to first, and there are two away.
Now batting, third baseman, Gio Urshela.
That'll bring in Giovanni Urshela. He was a strikeout victim to open up the ball game. Grounded down the third baseline, and that finds its way through for a base hit.
That was actually a well-executed fastball in to in off the plate. Credit the offensive player. He smelled that coming, turned and burned.
At the plate, Aaron Hicks. Swing and a liner. And that'll get down for a base hit.
Two quick outs from the 8-9 guys in the order, but the top of the order, it's a different story. A knock and then another single back-to-back, and now you got traffic with the big guys coming up.
In now, DJ LeMahieu. There's ball two as the slider dips below the zone.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
Lifted down the line in left. Left fielder giving chase. Into the corner, he makes the catch to end the inning. Yanks strand a pair. They trail it here 3-0. And stepping in, number 23, 0-for-1 for him here in this one. The 1-1. Swing and a liner. And that will fall in front of Stanton. It's a base hit.
A lot of smiles to go around on the offensive side. First time through the order. That's already their sixth hit today as a team.
Blake now, Chang, a ball and two strikes now. Two strikes. to 2 balls and 2 strikes now. And this is swung on and missed. 5 quick strikeouts now, and that's your first out of the inning. So with one gone, let's take a brief glance at our upcoming schedule to see what's coming up here on the show. Next will be the designated hitter, Chen. He doubled his last time up.
And he's got to build off that last AB. He battled. Usually when you battle, you get in that swing mode. A lot of pitches, you'll swing at the rosin bag. I love the fact that he was able to work a double in last at bat. Let's see if we get more of the same right here.
Runners on first with one down. Pops this one up. Kluber is calling for it. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away.
Now batting, number 24.
And now, number 24, looking to follow up the RBI single from his first at-bat. Ready on 3-1, here's the pitch. Hit in the air to right center field. This ball is carrying well. Back it goes, and it is out of here. So it's a 2-run shot to right center, second home run early in the year as they extend the lead to 5-0. If you're right here, then leave me alone. I gotta
go, get to the dough. When they call us, so I pick up the phone. Wow, nothing more demoralizing than giving up 3 home runs in the first 3 innings of a game. There's having a guy's number, and then there's absolutely owning him. This could be the latter.
Stepping in now, number 17. Fooled by the speed and location of that one, it's 2-2. And the inning goes away in unceremonious fashion on a swing and a miss at a ball way outside the strike zone. But 2 come across to score in the inning courtesy of this 2-run home run. We played 3 full, and the lead is now 5-0. Leading off the inning, it'll be Kyle Higashioka, and they could use a spark from him here. And the count will be full. Swing and a liner. A leaping try, but it's out of his reach and into the outfield.
Boy, talk about being a game of inches, D-Row. That was a bullet just out of the reach of the third baseman.
Yeah, third base is just a reactionary position, kind of a la goalie in hockey. He didn't have much chance there. He tried to make a play, get it above his head, but he was unable to get there.
At the plate, Tyro Estrada. Line to the right side. In there, a base hit. He'll hold it second, and there are 2 aboard now. Definitely not the way he was looking to start this inning, Dan.
Yeah, Matt, back-to-back base knocks right off the bat here. As we take a look at the numbers, you see they aren't that bad, but he's definitely got into a no-out jam here. We'll see if he can get out of it.
To the plate now, Gio Urshela lifted down the line in left. But this is going to wind up a foul ball. Here comes the 1-2. Higashioka over at second. Estrada on at first with nobody out. Hit in the air down the right field line. Number 24 is there, and he has it for the out.
Good read there at second base to know he could make it to third on the flyout. Now he's only 90 feet away with one out.
Next to stand in is Aaron Hicks. He's singled in 2 trips to the plate thus far. No runs on 6 hits and no errors for the Yankees so far. 1-1 pitch and a good sinker there, but he can't find the zone. 2-1.
He's got a couple of pitches to deal with right here, but he's starting to lose command of his pitches. It might be time to take a step back and try to refocus on making some good pitches.
Catch is made here in right, and here comes the runner from third. And they're going to get on the board here with the sack fly, but there's still work to be done, down 5-1.
Great job there by this power hitter, known for driving the ball out of the ballpark. Does the job right there with the sack fly and brings the run home.
Runner on first with two away. Timing just a tick off there as this one's fouled off to the right. Here now the 2-2. He is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. A run on two hits for the Yankees. Last half of the fifth coming up. Chinese Taipei is out in front 5-1. Garcia is into the ball game now as he'll make his fifth appearance of the season here.
Davey Garcia.
Bottom of the inning now, and striding forward the designated hitter, Chen. Ready to deal, here's the 1-1.
Two balls, one strike.
Looked like he was a little over-aggressive there to throw that nasty curveball. Just needs to slow his delivery down a bit.
The 2-1. Will not catch the zone, ball three. Number 24 waits on deck. And that one misses, so the leadoff man will head down to first on ball four to start the bottom of the sixth.
Now batting, number 24.
So the next to bat will be number 24. He's off to a fast start in this one, 2-for-2, including a home run. From the stretch, here's a ball hit high down the right field line. This ball has a chance, and it is gone. So a two-run homer down the line in right field, his second home run of the game, as it's now a six-run ball game. Long ball is playing in this one. That was the fourth blast of the game so far for this lineup. Dan, D-Row, what are your thoughts on what they're doing as a team so far?
Matty V, D-Row, I don't know what you think, but this is like crazy. Fourth round tripper of the game so far.
They're missing over the heart of the plate, not using the quadrants. In the hitter's meeting, they focused on this stuff. They thought these guys could miss middle, and that's exactly what's happening.
Oh, that's a tough call for Blue right there. Either way you call it, somebody doesn't like it. But, hey, that's the life of an umpire.
Bases are empty here, nobody out. This is skied into short left center. On the move is Stanton. He gets there and makes the play for the first out.
Now batting, number 13.
Next, here is Chen, flew out last time up. Still only one out in the inning. He takes strike three called on the fastball. Couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away. Pretty clear he didn't like the call there on the outside part of the plate, but probably too good to take, and he's down on strikes for the second time.
Yeah, that pitch was right on the black. Beautiful pitch. And even if we had robot umps, he'd still be out. But the only difference would be he wouldn't be able to complain about it.
Struck him out. Struck him out again, I should say. His third punch out of the game. A two come across to score in the inning courtesy of this two-run home run. Bottom third of the order, 7-8-9, due up to start the top of the Yankee order. Digging in, Gio Urshela. We're in the eighth now, and nothing's changed out there on the mound.
Well, I've been very impressed with how this starter's going.
Now here comes the skipper out of the first base dugout heading for the mound. And a change is in the offing, as that'll be all for his starter this afternoon. So he receives a nice ovation from this home crowd, departing after surrendering just one earned run.
Ladies
number 16 is on, and he'll take
please.
Over on the mound
now
in relief.
Number 16.
Out of the stretch, the 3-2 pitch home. Hit on the ground out to short. Reined in. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number 8. And there's a final look at the numbers for the starter in this one. It was a really nice day on the mound for him.
Matty B, really a solid performance. 7 strong innings pitched, in line for the win. Needs some help for the bullpen to close this one out.
Into the box, Aaron Hicks. Nope. He loses ball him on ball 4.
Well, he gives up the walk, but that was a really good pitch.
Now
might have been just out of the zone, but not by much. A lot of guys would have gone fishing for that pitch, so sometimes the hitter just outlasts you.
Stepping in now, DJ LeMahieu. In the dirt, and now let's see. And he can't hold on to the throw as it short hops him and eats him up.
Well, the intent there with that 2-strike pitch was obviously to get him to fish for something he couldn't do a whole lot with, but there's the risk that comes with that as well. If you don't execute or your catcher can't handle it very well, you give up 3 bases.
Liner towards second, and that's in there. Base hit. And the runner from second will stay put at third, so they're runners at the corners now with one away.
Number 99.
Hey, guys, I understand it right there. The third base coach has got to hold them up. They're down by a lot of runs right now. No reason to risk getting a guy thrown out at home in this situation.
Into the box now, Aaron Judge. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2.
Well, the Yankees have been searching for that big hit pretty much all game. It remains to see if they can get it, but now it sure would be a good time.
Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. Now another 1-2. Line drive to left. In there, base hit, and that ought to get the run in from third. Oh, and the throw back in is a wild one.
Now batting.
So some real problems out there that time as it'll wind up in E7. At the plate, Gleyber Torres. There's a good breaking ball as it gets the bottom of the zone.
Put that in the memory bank. First time he breaks out a curveball right there, and it's a pretty good one.
Sent on the ground out to second. Throw will be to first for the second out, but meanwhile, another run is in to score.
They get the run there, but this late in the game with the lead in hand, you'll definitely trade an out for a run that doesn't mean a whole lot.
So here is Luke Voit, runner in scoring position with 2 gone. Judge at third with 2 away. Now a changeup, but it misses just a little below the zone. Swung on and missed, and it's even at 2-2. From the belt, kicks and deals. Hit out towards second. And that's through into center field. Base hit. And the runner from third crosses the plate.
Yeah, one a day keeps the doctor away, Dan, especially when it's a big one late in the game. It doesn't matter at all. You're just trying to get one knock a day, find a couple barrels. He happened to catch his late.
Boy, I tell you what, you're talking about coming at a good time, too. You have a kind of a rough night, last AB. You end up being able to do something positive, not only for yourself, but also helping the team out, too.
Bouncer up the middle, fielded cleanly. The throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. So they pick up 3 runs on 3 hits, 2 errors in the inning, and 1 man left on. home half of the eighth straight ahead. Chinese Taipei leads this one to shut things down here in the ninth. Here's the 1-2. And he wasn't going to hit that one with an or. The strikeout, and there's one gone. And with strike three recorded there, he's notched his first career major league strikeout.
Well, Matt, if he can become a consistent strikeout pitcher, you have to figure his career is going to end up being a solid one. All the best pitchers at this level have at least one pitch that they can go into in tough situations. So we'll see if he becomes one of those guys as his career goes along.
Standing in now, Tyro Estrada. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Two and two.
That's the exact spot to lean on as a reliever. As a hitter, you just have to tip your cap and look for the next one.
One out, nobody on. And it's another K. So back-to-back strikeout victims to start this relief outing.
Well, you have to feel pretty confident about the way this one's going to end up as a manager. Two hitters, two strikeouts from the closer. There's not a whole lot more he can do to instill confidence that he's going to wrap this thing up without any problem.
Last chance for the Yankees. Line towards center field. And that's in for his second hit of the afternoon. So the two-out base hit on the top of the inning is still alive.
And if you're the manager, you've got to love that about your team. They were down to their last strike, but they refused to go down without a fight, so they live to fight some more.
To the plate now, Aaron Hicks. Hit out towards second. Scooped up. Throw on to first is in time to get him. And the Tycoons will put an end to their three-game skid as this ball game is over. 7-4 the final finish today. The Tycoons posted a three-run first to propel them to the win. Number 40 gets the win on the mound, his first of the year. Quo closes the door for the save, his third of the campaign. So that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.
Now it's our final line score. First, for your victorious home team, 7 runs on 10 hits. 2 errors, they left 4 runners on base. For the Yankees, 4 runs on 10 hits. No errors, they left 8 men on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 29 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this afternoon. And we remind you to please drive home safely.